So we've touched on several reasons why businesses should invest in a PEL, but could you quickly summarize why facilities managers, electrical contractors, and business owners should buy a power and energy logger? Hello, I'm Jess from PASS. Welcome to PASS Presents. Today I'm joined by Kevin Smith, Chauvin Arnoux's Head of Commercial Operations. Welcome, Kevin.
Hello.
Thank you for joining us. Today we're going to be talking about Chauvin Arnoux's power and energy loggers. Mm-hmm. In later videos, we'll be talking specifically about the PEL 51, PEL 104, and PEL 106. But for now, we're going to be talking about power and energy loggers more generally. So Kevin's going to discuss what they are, what they can be used for, and why you need one. Hopefully you'll find this interesting and informative. However, if we do miss anything, please feel free to leave questions in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe and share this video with anyone you think might find it interesting. So let's start by defining what a PEL is. What is a PEL?
Okay, so a PEL is a power and energy logger. So it's a very simple form of sort of power quality analyzer that logs the parameters for an electrical installation over a period of time. Okay. So we can use this to log simple things like current or voltage, or more complex parameters, things like harmonics maybe, or power factor, things like that. But the important thing is we're logging over a long period of time, so we get a typical operation of the installation. So something like a simple clamp meter, we just take a single reading, but that just gives you an instantaneous reading, whereas with a power and energy logger, we're logging over a period of time so we can see the installation under all of the different parameters.
And what do you mean when you say a long period of time, a day, a week, a month, a year?
Ideally, the longer the better, because you get a better averaging effect and you understand what's going on. So particularly like now we're coming into winter. So if you logged in the winter and in the summer, you would capture different parameters. Some customers you may only be able to log for a day or a week or something like that. But ideally, we want to be able to capture typical operation. So usually that'd be over, say, a week or maybe a month, depending on the job that you're actually logging.
Okay. And how are they different from power quality analyzers?
Generally, a power and energy logger monitors what we call trends. So it's looking for things that are occurring over a longer period of time, whereas a power quality analyzer will generally do that. Most power quality analyzers will do that. But power quality analyzers are generally looking for faster events like spikes and surges and things like this within an installation.
Yeah.
Whereas the power and energy logger doesn't really look at the very fast events. It's looking for trends over a longer period of time.
Okay. So what can they measure? You mentioned current and voltage.
That's basically it. So what they do is this, people think that power and energy logging is quite sort of complex, but realistically you're measuring voltage, you're measuring current, and you're tracking that against time.
Okay.
So from voltage and current, we can work out power, we can work out power factor, we can work out harmonics. So they're all voltage and current measurements. So when we connect it up, we connect up a voltage connection, we connect up a current connection, and the logger is obviously measuring that against the time axis. But from that, we can then derive all of the other more complex parameters.
How are they measuring this? Are they left in place? Do they log it? Do they stream the readings via Wi-Fi? How did it work?
Generally, a bit of backwards, really. So you could use these for just doing a real-time measurement. So you could connect it up, look at the readings, just like you would do a simple, say, clamp meter. Generally, we said we'd normally connect them up for a period of time, whether that's a week, a month, or whatever it is, and we're looking over a period of time. Now, normally the results would be recorded onto the SD card within the instrument, so the data's been stored, because you're talking a lot of data.
Yeah.
You know, this is hundreds of readings every second is being stored, so it's a lot of data. However, in advanced devices like the PEL 104, that we're talking about, you can connect via Wi-Fi, you can connect via a SIM card and things like this. So more and more customers want to be able to dial into their installation and see what's going on and download these things. So the increased connectivity features of things like the PEL 104 just adds that extra level. But most customers leave it in place, download the readings to the SD card, and then take those off at the end of the logging period and look at it in the software.
As I understand it, PELs can be used for all sorts of things, from optimizing energy efficiency to monitoring EV charging points to finding faults. Could you run through just some of the applications of PELs, please?
Yeah, certainly. So as you say, energy efficiency is a big thing at the moment. Yeah. The price of electricity just keeps going up. And if you're a managing director of a company, you're a finance director, you're a facilities manager, you're getting a big electricity bills and you want to do something about it. And often they don't know where to start. Well, a great place to start is do some power and energy logging with something like a PEL, because then you can look at your electrical installation, you can understand where all the electricity is going, and then you can put a business case together to prioritize the changes that you're going to make to the installation. Yeah. And then you can check again afterwards to make sure that you have actually made the savings and continue to tweak that over time.
Yeah.
So energy efficiency is a big part of the power and energy logger. Energy efficiency is something that's huge for us at the moment. Yeah. But like you say, you can use them for all sorts of things. So power, actually looking at the power of an electrical installation. So EV charging points, PV systems are very sensitive to the voltage of the electrical installation, the voltage of the grid. And that can actually fluctuate quite a lot nowadays because the grid's getting quite old and tired. So if you were to install an EV charging point and actually find that because of the voltage instability, that overnight potentially the voltage goes a bit high and it switches off the charging point, so your car doesn't charge up, it can cause problems. So knowing in advance by doing some logging actually tells you that your voltage is within the parameters expected from the grid, and therefore obviously you're going to have a reliable installation. So that's the same for EV, it's the same for PV. In PV also, particularly with battery systems, you want to be able to size the system correctly. Mm-hmm. So if you're going to size the system correctly, you don't want to just go in and put solar panels everywhere because it could be quite expensive. You want to know exactly how many do you use, what size battery do you need. And people are using the PELs to actually do surveys in advance to make sure that they get that sort of thing right.
Yeah.
There's also the power quality side of things. So things like power factor correction, and harmonic. These are traditionally more power quality type things that you would use a power quality analyzer for. But actually, the more advanced PELs like the PEL 104 will actually cross over and start to do some of those parameters as well. So they're being used in more industrial type installations for that sort of analysis and fault finding.
So they can sort of reduce your electricity bill, reduce your emissions, and sort of help with like green initiatives, basically.
Definitely, yeah. I mean, that's one of the areas we're seeing a lot of growth is with green and renewable businesses, where they're starting to look at these. Even like I say, heat pumps is a thing nowadays. A lot of heating engineers aren't traditionally electricians, but they're having to deal with things like heat pumps could be very big loads in installation. And they need to know, can actually fit this heat pump without overloading the installation. So even heating engineers are starting to look at things like the PELs for doing services in advance of installing heating systems.
Okay. Given their versatility, who could benefit from using a PEL?
I would say, almost anybody, nowadays. I think the PEL, particularly for if it's sort of domestic and like commercial installations, we've got the PEL 51 now, which is a single phase power and energy logger. And the traditional PELs, the PEL 103, 104, are single phase, three phase type installations. But I think electricians now are starting to add these into their toolkit. It's almost a standard part of their toolkit nowadays. So I think over time, this will just be a standard tool that every electrician will have and will see the benefits of.
So are we thinking sort of electricians, facilities managers, heat engineers?
Yeah, I mean, we're sort of targeting at the moment, they're starting to get more into the electrical contractor market. So electricians are having this to do sort of a service they can offer to their customers. But they are relatively simple to use. So like you say, sometimes businesses will buy one so that they can use it themselves to keep an eye on their electrical installation. We even have some businesses where they install them permanently. So they just put them in, install them permanently, and then they can connect in via the computer and see what's going on with their installation on a sort of semi-permanent basis.
Yeah.
So it sort of covers everything, really.
Yeah. Versatile. So it seems with the current convergence of environmental and energy crises, now has never been a better time to invest in a power and energy logger. There are already initiatives for businesses to enact effective environmental policies. Quite often it's criteria essential to securing lucrative contracts or tenders. And the streamlined energy and carbon reporting SECR regulations enacted in 2019 require qualifying UK businesses to disclose their energy use, carbon emissions and energy efficiency. However, Chris Coth explained in his article for the January 2023 edition of FMJ, which is the Facilities Management Journal, that although 39% of global carbon emissions can be attributed to buildings, with 28% of emissions resulting from operational activities, power, heating and cooling, that sort of thing, 62% of facilities managers surveyed by IWFM, which is the Institute of Workplace and Facilities Management, felt that they did not have access to the necessary data required to make meaningful changes. So it appears to me that PELs provide a simple solution to this. So could you perhaps say a bit more about how power and energy loggers help organisations meet their financial and policy targets? And second to that, the crucial role these meters will continue to play as the UK works to meet net zero targets.
Yeah, so this is looking more at the energy side of a power and energy logger side of things, as we spoke about earlier. And yeah, a lot of electrical installations, remember this is an electrical device, so we're only monitoring the electrical energy.
Yeah.
So like if you've got a heating system and stuff like that, you wouldn't necessarily be able to track that part of it. But certainly the electrical energy usage, we could connect up the PEL, we can look at the electricity usage over a period of time. And the great thing with a PEL is you can connect it up at the origin of the installation and monitor the whole installation.
Yeah.
But because it's a portable device, you can move it around then to specific circuits, particular departments, particular pieces of equipment, and actually build up a picture of the whole electrical installation over time. And one of the things that we talk about is actually being able to sort of look at return on investment. So you can actually say, right, if we've got, for example, in our office, we looked at our office in Dewsbury and actually prioritised some changes there. So we went to LED lighting. We changed some of the lighting in the warehouse. We added some infrared heaters where we've got big gas heaters and things like that. But we could actually look at the return on investment. We could prioritise the order in which we did those. And we can do before and after studies to see the difference.
Yeah.
And the other thing, as I've mentioned previously, is you can monitor these over a period of time. So within any business, things change throughout the 12 months.
Yeah.
So, you know, what you're using in the summer on air conditioning and what you're using for heating in the winter and things like that can be totally different.
Mm-hmm.
And also businesses evolve and change. So you add on new parts to the business, new services, people move out, people move in. So you can continue to monitor these things over a period of time. The other great thing that we've seen more of now from an environmental point of view with the power and energy loggers is people actually using these to calculate their carbon footprint.
Yeah.
So the great thing with these is these are basically energy monitors. So these are looking at your kilowatt hours, your usage of electricity. But if you know what source you're using for your electricity, you can actually convert that into tons of CO2 equivalent. So we actually have people where, particularly in the entertainment industry, in the events industry, like festivals, they want to have a carbon neutral festival. So they'll connect up the PELs to the electrical generators and the electrical systems that they're using. And off the back of that, they can look at carbon offsetting. So they can potentially look at planting trees and things like that to offset the carbon that's actually used. So we're not just monitoring the energy side of things. We can then flip that into carbon and look at carbon footprints, which is something that customers are really starting to get more interested in.
Yeah, and especially as they're often like asked for in tender criteria.
Yeah.
I didn't realise that they were used at festivals. That's really cool. So we've touched on several reasons why businesses should invest in a PEL, but could you quickly summarise why facilities managers, electrical contractors and business owners should buy a power and energy logger?
Okay. So there's several reasons for this. One, the price of electricity is getting more and more expensive.
Mm-hmm.
So where we use it and what we use it for never used to be quite as important as it is now, because everybody wants to know where every kilowatt is going within the business to really optimize electrical installation. So the price of electricity has driven that.
Mm-hmm.
There's also the drive to net zero, which we talked about, which means people are more conscious of where their energy is going. There's the new environmental technologies. So now we've got prosumers, we've got people who are creating, generating electricity themselves, storing it in batteries. A lot of that can be really complicated to analyse.
Mm-hmm.
We've also got the state of the UK mains grid, which is getting more and more unstable because, you know, it's creaking at the seams and they're having to deal with all these new challenges like PV and wind turbines and all sorts of mix of energy that's going in there. So the electrical grid has never been more sort of unstable and diverse. We've got a new balance of products like PV and EV and heat pumps and all these sort of things in there. Add that to the really sort of increased emphasis on energy costs because of the price of electricity and zero carbon. The only way really to get a grip of that is to actually measure it.
Yeah.
And have some proper data. We've talked to electricians over a period of time where they try and do what they call maximum demand calculations. So in the regs book, there'll be standard calculations of how to work out what your electrical installation draws. But these calculations are probably over 20 years old. You know, they're quite complicated and they don't really capture what's going on in electrical installation nowadays with any degree of accuracy. So trying to calculate it with a pen and paper and a calculator is almost impossible.
Mm.
Whereas to put a power and energy logger on for, say, a week, you'll be able to see the exact figures, you know exactly what's going on, what time of day, and you're using proper evidence data to make your decisions, not an estimate.
So they can improve your energy usage sort of now and in the future.
Yeah. Like, I mean, it gives you the data. It gives you the data to make informed decisions.
Yeah.
And that's really what you're getting with a power and energy logger. One of the influencers we work with says you can't see electricity. Yeah. You know, the only way to see electricity is to use something like a power and energy logger or a power quality analyzer to give you that information. And that's really what it puts in your hand.
Helps you to spend money wisely as well, doesn't it?
It does. You can see really what's going on. And also the time perspective is very important because, you know, there's a massive percentage of electrical usage within businesses. I think it's as much as like 40% can be out of hours.
Yeah.
So you're going along to,
I think it's
what's all this? Yeah. So you think, what's this going on? You know, out of hours, all this stuff. So you wouldn't know that necessarily because when you're there trying to take measurements or to look what's going on, you're not going to be there.
No.
So this will be sat there monitoring the installation constantly. So that's another reason for electricians really, is it's something they can leave, go away, be earning money elsewhere, and then come back and have the data. They haven't got to be sat there constantly monitoring what's going on.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll go into the specifics of Chauvin Arnoux's range of PELs in subsequent videos.
Yeah.
But for the time being, could you just give us a taster of what's to come? Why should people invest in a Chauvin Arnoux power and energy logger?
As we've talked about, really, the power and energy logger is becoming an essential tool for electricians and businesses from that side of things. So anybody who wants to get a grip on what's going on with electrical installations over a period of time really needs a power and energy logger to be able to do that. And there's loads of reasons we've talked about for energy efficiency, or if they're looking to add to or alter an electrical installation, getting the data up front to be able to put together business cases for energy efficiency improvements, and also to monitor that afterwards. So for all of those reasons, really, having a power and energy logger is essential nowadays for anybody involved with electricity or running electrical installations.
But why specifically Chauvin Arnoux?
Why specifically Chauvin Arnoux? Ah, okay. So why Chauvin Arnoux? The differentiator really with Chauvin Arnoux is we've put a lot of time, you know, we've Chauvin Arnoux is 130 years old this year. So we've been doing this a while, you know, we're saying we've been around as long as electricity, and that actually is true. But Chauvin Arnoux, we've been in the UK about 35 years, and one of the areas we really specialise in is power quality and energy efficiency. So you're really dealing with, we like to describe ourselves as your experts, so we're effectively there to help and support our customers through, and that's really been one of the big differentiators, is we spend a lot of our time out on site with customers, working with customers, supporting customers, and actually, you know, demonstrating products, taking products out there. We get involved on a lot of fun projects as well, as sort of, we recently went down to London to monitor a block of flats for a customer, because they basically post on Facebook, electrician, how do I know what electricity has been used in this block? The five flats, I've been told by the electricity supplier that we need to upgrade the supply. It's going to cost tens of thousands of pounds. What do we do? Mm-hmm. So we said, well, we'll come down with you. We'll hold your hand through it. We'll do some monitoring and we'll have a look what's going on. And we actually went down, we took a PEL down, we connected up for a week. We went back and looked at the results. And actually, this whole block of flats was hardly drawing anything.
Really?
Yeah, because they got gas central heating. It was only sort of single people living in the flats. They weren't there that much. So we actually used that data then. They could go back to the distribution network operator, the DNO, and prove that no, they didn't need it all upgraded. They didn't need to spend tens of thousands of pounds. They could just do some update work on the origin of the installation just to bring it up to date, but they didn't need to update the cable, dig up the street, all that lot. So off the back of that, that was just something we worked with the customer to help them. And off the back of that, we had a sort of a case study that we put together. But that's just an example of how we go the extra mile to sort of support our customers and really help with using our products and actually getting people sort of familiar with the application, because we recognise it's a new application for many electricians. A lot of people haven't really got into it. They're just starting to understand that journey. So we're there to help them with that. And we create loads of videos and webinars and all sorts of things, as well as sort of the one-to-one support that we offer to customers.
So would you say you choose Chauvin Arnoux, the experience, the expertise and the support?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I couldn't have said it better.
Thank you. Okay, excellent. Thank you for speaking with us today.
No problem at all.
It was very informative. I hope you found that helpful. If you did, please like and subscribe and share this with anyone you think might find it useful. As ever, if we've missed anything, please do leave us a comment. Alternatively, you can contact a member of our sales team. Finally, remember to look out for future episodes in which we'll be talking about Chauvin Arnoux's PEL 51, PEL 104 and PEL 106. If you want to get ahead, information on all of those models can be found on our website, www.tester.co.uk.